video, we'll be looking at the new soft delete feature in Google Cloud Storage. We'll do this in a hands-on way and jump right in. First, we'll create a bucket that we're going to use for our soft delete demonstration. As of the time of this recording, the soft delete policy is by default enabled. You can uncheck that, but note that when it is checked, it's going to give you 7 days of retained versioning. This is quite useful in case you accidentally delete files, as they can be restored at any time. This is a sensible default, as often you will have critical data in these Google Cloud Storage buckets, and you don't want to risk deleting them accidentally. Let's take a screenshot here, and we will bring that image into our bucket to demonstrate. After uploading the image, we can use this as a normal object, and note that we get a preview of the image down below. But if we delete this object, even from the console, we should still have the ability to retrieve it. To view soft deleted objects, check out the filter. Here, we see one soft deleted version. Clicking on this will display the soft deleted object version, along with other information. At this point, we can easily restore the object. Note that this is true regardless of how you delete these objects, and the soft delete duration will be based on the number of days that you configure. If you want, you can also work with these settings via the Google Cloud CLI. For instance, you may decide to disable the setting. You can do so with the command storage buckets update followed by clear soft delete for the specific bucket. If you refresh the page, you will see that the soft delete feature is now disabled. This is a bash command, so you could of course pipe things together to disable this feature for all your buckets if desired. We hope that this video is informative and we'll be monitoring the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching and please enjoy responsibly.